Hello, and welcome back to the future. The game, episode 2. I don't know what episode of my playthrough this is, but welcome back anyway. We start off exactly where we left off last time. We just got back. We have saved Grandpa Artie. We are not going to fade into non-existence. Due to time, space, reality, dimension, timey-wimey, dimensionally, wenchly sort of stuff. We're back home, and there is a crate in the middle of the drive.
Dad must have used that to haul away all those books from Doc's estate sale.
My dad is a jerk. So is my grandpa.
Biff finished the wax job on my 4x4.
I think the only decent member of the family is my mother and me, possibly. So I guess we'll go home. See what has changed, if the movies are anything to be judged by.
Hey, anyone home? There's something wrong with my key.
Please, not now. Tomorrow. Give me another what? Day.
Things have changed.
Another day? Dad, what are you talking about?
Marty? No, that's impossible. Marty was run out of town.
Uh-oh.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Echoes of Back to the Future 2? Possibly.
Run out of town? What are you talking about, Dad? Let me in.
This is a trick. Go away.
Leave us alone. Haven't we suffered?
Just look through the window.
Mom, it's Marty, Mom. Open up.
It sounds like Marty, but it must be a trick.
Mom!
Go away. Shame on you.
How can I convince you?
Tell me something only Marty would know.
I've got a scar on my left knee.
From what?
Skateboarding down the courthouse steps when I was 12.
That's right.
Oh, my lord. What are you waiting for, George? Let him in.
Stupid locks.
Marty.
Marty. Oh, my God, Dad. What happened to you?
What do you think happened, butthead?
Biff.
I thought we told you to stay out of town, shrimp.
Biff, whatever's going on, I'm sure we can handle it. Reasonably. Who are they?
Like you don't know Cliff and Riff. What do you think we should do with them, baby bro? What we should have done years ago, big bro. I'm gonna enjoy this, McFly.
Wait, I'm trying to process here. Where do these other Tannens come from?
From a mommy Tannen and a daddy Tannen. It's called the birds and the bugs, butthead.
Tell me. How long have you been coming down on my dad like this?
Ever since that school dance, when Georgie laid Biff out in the parking lot. Shut up, it's not funny. Someone messes with the Tannen family never lets him forget about it.
I got a question. Why are you guys so pissed at me?
You don't remember? You've really lost it, McFly.
Dude, manure.
Think back, the thing with the manure truck.
Which one? Here's what I still don't understand. What about my mom? I mean, how did she end up with my dad?
Beats us. Guess she has a thing for losers.
Yeah.
She could have had any one of us, but she went for old Gimpy McFly.
Ooh. Gimpy McFly, that's...
And another thing. What are you guys doing here anyway?
It's that time of the month. Time for Georgie to pay up. We usually take the payment in cash, but this month we can take it out of your hide.
Here's what I still don't understand. Why can't you pick on somebody else?
We do. We pick on lots of guys. It's kind of our thing.
Well, that seems obvious.
I was wondering.
Don't.
And another thing.
Okay, I was going back and forward now.
2 years ago. Don't you remember? We made a deal that we'd go easier on your old man if you left. But now you're back, so the kid gloves can come off.
Ooh. Biff! Wait, does all this have something to do with Kid Tannen?
Pop? What about him?
He was supposed to end up in jail.
Jail? Pop's never spent a day in jail in his life. The Tannen Gang's the fifth most dangerous crime family in California. We got connections all over the place.
No way.
You don't believe me?
Oh, Biff, no!
Bang! Ha ha! Check it out.
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, JJ Valenti.
That's Don Valenti, godfather of the Sacramento mob. The third most dangerous crime family in California.
Ooh. Okay, but... Biff, what happened to you? When I left here, you were kind of afraid of my dad.
Afraid? No Tannen ain't never been afraid of no McFly.
Ooh. One more question. What the hell did you do to my dad?
Your dad's been in that wheelchair since before you were born, butthead. And you better hope he has a spare, because you're gonna need one in like 3 seconds.
Ooh. I was wondering.
Don't.
How do I end this questioning?
And another thing. Look, can't we bury the hatchet already?
Even better idea. I bury this 9-iron up your backside. Ooh. Hey!
Let me ask.
Shut it.
Okay, tell me
no
this.
No more questions.
Ooh. Okay, tell me
no
this.
No more questions.
Ooh. Okay, tell me
no
this.
No more questions.
Well, it's not going anywhere.
Ooh. Let me...
Shut it.
I was wondering.
Box is over here now.
Oh. I was wondering.
Don't.
I think...
Okay, tell me
no
this.
No more questions.
I think I'm seeing... something? There we go.
Piece of cake.
Lug nuts.
I never should have let that floozy talk me out of rubbing out your grandfather.
Oh, is this kid?
Huh? Kid?
No one in Hill Valley messes with the Tannen family.
We can't get Peggy. Apart from Doc Brown.
Marty, get in. This timeline.
You don't say.
No kidding.
Somehow, something we did in 1931 allowed Kid Tannen to escape his date with justice. As a consequence, the Tannens have been unchecked in Hill Valley for over 50 years.
jeez, they robbed the arcade.
We've got to go back to the day Kid Tannen was supposed to be arrested. Figure out what went wrong and fix it. Otherwise, you could be forever stuck in a town owned by the Tannens.
Not an option, Doc. Punch it.
I hope in this series, whatever episode, we actually get to go to the future. I mean, as fun as it is to mess about in the past, I want to go to the future. It's a time machine. We can go to the future, surely.
Okay, Doc, let's run through this again.
Sometime tonight, Kid Tannen is supposed to be betrayed by his mole, the singer named Trixie Trotter.
That hot babe I saw coming out of the speakeasy.
Exactly. When she does, history says Tannen will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
Parker. Hey, do you think he's related to Jennifer Parker, my girlfriend?
Could be.
Heavy.
In any event, somehow we've changed history so that neither of these events happens. Condemning your family to generations of abuse at the hands of the Tannen crime family. You need to go back into Tannen's speakeasy, find out what's gone wrong, and get Kid Tannen arrested.
No problem, Doc. Let me just put on my hat and I'm good to go. Is the mustache really necessary?
It's essential. You can't let Kid know that you're the same troublemaker that foiled his attempt to kill me.
Are you sure you can't come in with me?
It's far too dangerous. You may be easy to disguise with your nondescript features, but ever since my daring escape from the police and the mob, my distinctive face has been plastered over every paper from here to Reno.
Nondescript?
I'll find a safe place to hunker down. That flop house ought to fit the bill. You can find me there if you need me.
So, does that mean we've got three versions of Marty? In the same era, or is this third version come slightly after number one and number two? Because we've also got at the very least two versions of Doc, possibly three. I mean, three certainly now, but whether that was after they went back to the past, so they timey-wimey stuff is confusing. What on earth is she doing out at this time, and what is this? What on earth?
Looks like Emmett's been busy. Looks like Emmett's been busy.
What? You're just gonna... Fine.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of kindness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's speakeasy.
Hey.
Am I right?
No.
No?
At least you possess enough shame to lie.
Hey.
Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me.
Oh, it's actually a song.
You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. What in heaven's name?
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Wait. Brown! Why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course.
What?
Hello, Harry.
Harry? Mr. Callahan, what are you doing in that getup?
Undercover.
I'm going undercover.
How exciting. You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime. Right now, I've got some souls to save.
Uh-huh.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things. Come by the gazebo when you get a chance. I'll be setting up. You won't believe what Einie and I have been up to.
Famous last words. All right. Now, where's that speakeasy?
Okay. So I've got a... Well, I'll talk to her again.
Hey, Edna.
Mr. Crockett, what can I do for
Jimmy
you?
Jimmy Crockett. What are you doing?
What are you doing out here in the middle of the night?
Saving people from alcohol, vice, and disorder. And also keeping a lookout for hot stories. You'd be surprised how much news breaks on this corner.
Broken any stories?
Broken any stories tonight?
Only the usual. Mayor Thomas trying to slink out of the speakeasy. Frankie Needles crashing his car into a fire hydrant. Nothing that'll get me the front page.
Anything about manure and the Tannens, maybe?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
No.
I can't tell her that. It could get him in trouble.
Oh.
What was that song you were singing?
It was awful, whatever it was.
I wrote it myself. It really gets the toes tapping at the Stay Sober Society meetings. Although I suppose that could be the shakes.
Yes.
Would you like to hear it again?
Go on then.
Sure.
I knew if I waited long enough, somebody would request it. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. It's not too late to redirect and start to care. Don't despise the good and pure. Time to rise up from the sewer. Wash off all that foul manure. Show the world you care. You should care. You should care. What people think of you. Of goals that you could name. Reclaiming your good name is what you ought to do. You should care. You should care. If your reputation is in disrepair, it's not going to hurt you to reclaim your virtue, for you should care.
Catchy.
You really think so?
Yeah, it's got a good hook to it.
One needs a good hook if one is fishing for souls.
Now, I've got a very limited experience of performing music and playing music. I've got no experience of writing music. But that was terrible. And it was obviously intended to be terrible. But I could see there was something there lyrically, weirdly enough. I could see there was something there. But, yeah. She can't play the... Is that technically called an accordion? I don't even know what that's actually called. It's an accordion style instrument, but yeah, I don't actually know what that is. But she can't play it. She potentially could sing. Lyrically, it was. You could definitely do something with that if you got the right chords and stuff, but. As I say, I'm not a musician. I am a gardener. So, what do I know? But, you know, it was... yeah.
What's going on with you and Emmett? The last time I saw you, you seemed to be kind of interested in him.
That was before I belatedly realized that his agreement to host my Stay Sober Society was a clever ruse to ferry barrels of hooch to his so-called laboratory.
Oh, she found that out,
sorry
did she?
About that.
Now his very presence fills me with an irrepressible urge to pick at his philosophical and intellectual foundations with every tool in my vocabulary.
So you're not dating?
Dating? The mere thought of romantic involvement with that undisciplined techno-anarchist is preposterous.
Rubbish. Good. You fancy him. You are totally... Totally fancy.
What's Kid Tannen been up to for the last 2 months?
Didn't you hear? It was in all the
nope.
papers.
I've been traveling.
Well, the feds were all set to arrest Tannen on tax evasion charges. Seems they'd gotten Tannen's books from his accountant.
I heard something about that, yeah.
Well, the accountant disappeared, unsurprisingly. But the Fed still thought they had a case. After all, they still had the books, right?
Uh-huh.
Right.
Wrong. The day before the trial, the books up and vanished right out of the court's evidence locker.
No.
Lots of fingers were pointed, but honestly, the whole town's so corrupt that it could have been anyone. Court clerks, cops, janitors.
Well, I'm pretty sure janitors wouldn't have access to evidence lockers. Unless in this time period they didn't actually have any locks.
So kids walking around free?
Free, clear, and laughing it up in his new speakeasy. The feds want to bring a case up against him, but without those books, they've got nothing.
So we need to get those books. That's what you're saying.
How's that song going over?
Oh, if only I could convince a few of these night owls to stop and listen. Would you like to hear it?
Not this time.
Maybe later.
I'll be here all night.
I'm sure you will.
Couldn't kid be brought up on other charges like, say, running a speakeasy?
In a perfect world, yes. But no one in town seems to care about prohibition anymore. The feds are only interested because of the lost tax revenue.
Yes.
Do you know anything about Officer Danny Parker?
Parker? Just another soul lost to the twin vices of booze and despair. I've asked him to tell me his story for my column. Sort of a cautionary tale, but he's never in the mood to talk to me.
You wouldn't happen to know anything about Trixie Trotter, would you?
Kid Tannen's latest conquest? Well, she claims to be a lounge singer from Seattle, but my sources in Washington have never heard of her. I mean, honestly, Trixie Trotter, what kind of name is that?
I believe it's called a stage name.
Whatever happened with that speakeasy arsonist?
I was about to ask you the same question.
Me?
Don't play coy with me. I may not have any journalistically acceptable proof, but I know you had a hand in Carl Sagan's daring escape from the authorities.
Maybe.
Didn't you think that Sagan was innocent?
I used to, but after he escaped, two more speakeasies were torched in Colfax and Georgetown.
That's just a coincidence.
Coincidence? Or is our friend Carl a serial arsonist?
Well, is he not doing basically what you wanted? Oops. Press the wrong button then. As long as it wasn't the echo button, I apologize.
I'm pretty sure that Carl Sagan didn't start those fires.
We'll see. One of the reasons I'm camped out so close to Tannen's new speakeasy is it gives me the chance to catch the arsonist in the act. It'd make a great story for my column.
So you're gonna let some thing burn down purposefully just so you can get a column? You need a "what is wrong with you" dialogue.
What have you got against dogs anyway?
They're smelly, rude, completely unable to take care of themselves, and frankly, they're not very bright. If I had my druthers, dogs would be banned from public
druthers.
Places.
Harsh.
It's a harsh world, Mr. Callahan.
Never, obviously never had a cat. How do I stop talking to her?
Broken any stories tonight?
Only the usual. Mayor Thomas trying to slink out of the speakeasy, framed to a fire hydrant. Nothing that'll get me the front page.
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
can't tell her that. It could get him in trouble. I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
I can't tell her that. It could get him in trouble.
Yeah.
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Kid Tannen arrested.
Oh, glorious day! When did it happen?
Well, it hasn't happened yet, but it's gonna.
Keep me posted.
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Well, it's a fight.